When I was like 21, I self-published a sci-fi novel about this band of misfits in space trying to make a quick buck, but they soon get way over their head in trouble. It was very much just Firefly, Cowboy Bebop, Guardians of the Galaxy, that sort of thing. And I really liked it. I mean, of course I would. It's basically just all my favorite things just put together into one package. Years later, there's a film on Netflix called Space Sweepers, which is also about a band of misfits out in space trying to make a quick buck, and then they find themselves over their head in trouble. And you know what? It fucking rocks. Here's the thing. There's not an original thought in the movie, and it's not that far beyond my own self-insert fanfiction, where I thought quoting Darkwing Duck was genius. That's not necessarily a bad thing. I mean, loads of people like rom-com movies, and they've all got the same tropes and actors and posters that you've seen time and time again. So why can't we just enjoy this Korean space blockbuster, which doesn't reinvent the wheel, more like buys a whole bunch and puts them all together.
What in God's name is that?
I call it an automobile.
I mean, I can't call it a masterpiece. I mean, I gave it 3.5 stars, but there's a lot of it that I really like. Watching the film, it's like if you bumped into someone from high school and you're all, oh, hey, Dan, how was the hockey injury? And then you realize it's 2005 and there's nothing new to talk about, but there's something that just sticks with you. Space Sweepers is like that. Firefly is a show from 20 years ago, created by someone not worth mentioning. It lasted one season, but there are people out there who still wish it could come back. It probably won't happen, but don't worry. Space Sweepers. Firefly took the idea of a spaceship of misfits flying under the law and just ran with it. And it made an entire generation of people think that Nathan Fillion could still play Nathan Drake even though he turns 50 this year. Compared to Firefly, Space Sweepers is a much more kind and inclusive space story set in a unified world that actually has Asian characters. I mean, you set up a world where America and China unite, and yet none of the main characters are Asian. Space Sweepers does well to diversify its cast because, shock, we're in space. So we've got all kinds of people flying about in space. You've got Koreans, Germans, French, English. Richard Armitage is in this movie for some reason. Of course there's going to be all kinds of people in space with their own reasons to be there. Our main characters' own motivations all come down to money. We eventually get their backstories to see why that is. But even from the get-go, you know they need to put food on the table and to fund their own personal quest. If anything, the crew of the ship is more like Cowboy Bebops than Fireflies. Except, instead of the dog, there's a robot and there's no martial arts. Like I said, 3.5 stars. Space Sweepers does well to show its motivations for its characters. Whether it's the main character who's trying to redeem himself for getting his daughter sucked off into space. Don't worry, it's a thing. Or the robot crewmate that just wants to buy a skin to show their true identity. Seriously, it's the smallest detail, but the male-sounding robot that wants to present as a female human is a nice little step in blockbuster filmmaking. Bit better than Superman Wear Black now. The best thing, however, is when the movie turns into Monsters, Inc. The crew of the ship find a child that is a danger to everyone because it turns out to be a robot with a hydrogen bomb inside them. And obviously, everyone wants the kid for their own reasons. It's up to our heroes to hide the kid until they can turn her over to the right people. But not before meeting the big bad guy. This guy's name, by the way? James Sullivan. It's literally the same name. I know that's not the name of the villain in Monsters, Inc., but it's a weird coincidence, right? There's also a bunch of stuff that's like Elysium, I guess? I mean, I fell asleep while watching it. Don't judge me. It's got great explosions, I'll give you that. Space Sweepers wants to touch on like similar themes such as class and the rich, and in this case, wanting to escape to Mars. If this isn't all just a huge Elon Musk analogy, then maybe that's the only thing that's not from popular culture here. Space Sweepers isn't exactly groundbreaking, but it's full of fun stuff. I like how this happens at the lowest point of the film.
Victory. System reboot. Complete.
I like that the kid draws cute pictures of the crew like she's Boo from Monsters, Inc. I like that there's a talking gun.
It's been a long time, Captain.
Wait, yeah, there's a talking gun. It's only in one scene, but the fact that it's in the film and it's treated like it's absolutely normal is crazy. Take that, Elysium, where's your talking gun? Thing is, Space Sweepers really is just the greatest hits of its genre, with a little bit of my favorite Pixar movie peppered onto there. And that's okay, because it's not trying to hide what it is. It's a solid remix, and you have to give it props for being the first Korean space blockbuster. It did its homework. Tropes aren't bad. We all love an airport chase, or a suicide mission, or a last-second victory. Hell, Cowboy Bebop is to Firefly, is to Guardians of the Galaxy, is all the way back to Star Wars. Sometimes the wheel doesn't need to be reinvented. Hell, you don't even need them in space.